Yeah, all right. So this is a fun song. It was a request by someone out there in YouTube land, so I'm giving it back. Awesome song. It's kind of like a bunch of guitar parts I'm going to fuse into one. And if you have a request out there of your own, go ahead and click that link down there somewhere, and that will get you to the request page. And, you know, who knows? Maybe I'll get to your song too. The list is long, but I'm getting through them. So anyways, let's zoom in for a closer look. Alright, so let's get into this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna, now there's multiple guitar parts, so I'm kind of fusing everything together. Now this part is really all slid or sliding, right? But since we're gonna kind of fuse everything together, I'm gonna hammer and then slide. So I'm gonna go 2, 4, slide on the A. And then I'm gonna grab with my second finger the third fret of the E. So we got. And then we're gonna go back to the same 4 and 5 on the A. So all together, 2, 4, slide to 5, 3 on the E, 4 and 5 on the A. And then I'm gonna use my fingers and pluck that D. So what I did was I went D, pull off to an open string with my first finger, and then I go to the D string. So we got, again, and then we go back to the G. So it's, back to the G, D, 4, 2, open. So, and then we got, I just went up, and then I hammered on the G string, 2 to 4. So I pluck it once, the next one is the same thing, slide up. Now the tricky part getting into the rhythm is as you're sliding up, mute, and then you're going to catch the chords on an upstroke. So it's, so every time I hit the chord, I'm going to go down, up, down, up. That keeps going, and then on the fourth time, or after the fourth time, there's a guitar part that's kind of like chord stabs. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to a B minor chord. Now this is the first real chord we're going to play in this version of it. So we're going to just hit the B minor, which is second fret A down with your first finger, and then this guy is on the B string, third fret. These two guys, fourth fret, D and G. Now what we're gonna do here is we're gonna go to like we're doing a G chord, but I'm gonna use my pinky and grab the fourth fret of the D string, and I'm gonna mute out the A string with this guy. So I'm gonna go 4, 2. Now you can keep this guy down too if you wanna do like the real D chord, because you got to go right into the D chord next. So we're going to go. So again, that's 4 and 2 on the D, and then we're going to go to the D chord. So all together. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. that twice before we get into the pre-chorus. So, all together, the beginning is. We're gonna go to a G chord. I'm just gonna do kind of, you know, like anthem rock, down, up, down, and let it ring, and then a couple mutes. All right, so what we're gonna do is, since there's multiple guitar parts going on in there, we're gonna go G chord. We're gonna go second finger on the G note, third fret of the E string, and I'm gonna tuck my ring and pinky in, B and E, third fret. Okay, so what I'm gonna do from there is I'm gonna go G. I'm going to, since there's two parts, one guy goes down like this. What we're going to do is we're going to combine those two parts. We're going to do a G with an A. So it's really an A chord with a G in the bass. Build up into our chorus. So from this part. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off with a D chord and think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? We're going to count that in between the chords. So we got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? You get the idea. So we're going to do a D chord. I'm going to do just kind of a rock D chord. I'm going to do my first finger on the second fret of the G string and my ring finger on the third fret of the B. And I'm not really going to play that down there. I'm just going to go D, G, B strings. And I'm going to do that same down, up, down. Let it ring for a little bit. So it's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to let it ring, you know, that down, up, down, and let it ring until I get to the 2 or 3, and then start coming in with the mutes. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and run, like eighth note. All right. So when I get to that G, I'm going to go second finger on the G note, third fret, E string, and then these two guys are on the B and E strings, third fret. And I'm just going to do the typical rock A. I'm going to use my first finger and bar the D, G, and B. We're gonna go back to G, back to A. So the whole sequence goes D to G, A, back to G, the half, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. first chorus ends with two quick stabs on the A. And then we're going to go back into... and then back into the verse. Now, the second verse, everything is identical until the very last part. And it's even the same chords, right? When we get to the... So when we're doing that hold on the A, 2, 3, 4, as a little ascending riff. So what I did right there is I hit it, second fret of the G, and then I hammered on to the fourth fret. So it's again, slide. So as soon as I get to the fourth fret, I slide to the sixth fret, then to the seventh fret. Back into the chorus. Chorus is the exact same with the exception of the end of the chorus. Instead of going, we're gonna actually build from there into a solo part that has just a little bit different variation on the chord progression. So let's go over the second chorus. It's gonna sound like this. Let's kick on some gain. Here we go. Go into a different progression for the solo. All right, so let's go over that solo section. By the way, a little side note, if you want to do the little higher guitar part in the chorus, you're basically just going to an A suspended chord. Like if this was right here, don't play the D. What we're going to do is we're going to hammer on from 6 to 7. We're gonna catch the A note on the high E string. I don't know the exact pattern, but that's what the riff is. Okay, so back into the solo riff. Chorus progression. So what we did was we went B minor to G to D, and then after I hit the A, I can go 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then from there, I'm going to do that 3 times. From there, I'm going to go straight to an E chord. Now you can do one finger. And I'm just doing 2 groups of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Same thing for G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And that gets you into where the band kind of drops down, and it's like a couple measures of just the guy singing with light chords in the background into the chorus again. And then from there, we just do the exact same thing we've normally done. And at the very end, we're gonna go back into right, that same riff. Just what we did in the solo. And And that, my friends, is it. All right. Awesome job. Another song in the bag. Like we like it around here. Cool, easy tune. If you have a request of your own, go ahead and put one in there. And I will make sure to get to it as quickly as possible. Also, if you like the more hard rock kind of thing, Papastache 102 is another channel I have. You know, you got old school metal, blues, you know, all the oldies but goodies. So, anyways, avail yourself of both channels. I would greatly appreciate it. And as always, thanks for watching. Catch you next time.